Happy almost new year, everyone. Welcome to Alive with Amanda. I'm excited to be here today. It's almost the new year. It's a really sort of like exciting time. You get to turn the page. You get to look forward to what's coming next. I think in terms maybe of our personal lives and a professional that is, seeped into there, we're really looking forward to turning the page on 2020. Though I know a lot of practices have been very booming in 2020. So it's almost been an interesting year because we've had this pandemic going on that has greatly impacted so many people. And a lot of practices are also doing really well. I foresee that that is going to continue into 2021. So I really want you to take some time. We already talked about goal setting, so I'm not going to talk about goal setting, but I really want you to think about your intentions, right? I really want you to think about turning the page on your practice from 2020 and going into 2021. And what can you do? And what do you want? And what can you manifest? And what can you bring? And what can you put into action to really make 2021 your year? Again, I don't think that mental health services are going to be in any less in demand. I think, in fact, they're going to be more in demand. I think you're going to see the same level of phone calls. You're going to see the same level of requests. And so if you're starting your private practice, this is a great time because people are calling, the phones are ringing, people need services right now. And so 2021 is going to be a really great year for mental health. Even as maybe people are still going back to work, kids are going back to school, life is going to hopefully, go back to a normal or a new normal, whatever you want to call it. I think that people have really been clued into mental health, how important that is, and they've needed the support. And insurance companies, for those of you who take insurance, have really gotten on the bandwagon in terms of offering telehealth, which will just increase people's access to mental health services. And I don't think that's going to go away. Again, the takeaway from our live today, this is the last live of the year. Thank you so much for being with me all throughout the year. It's been really fun doing these lives, answering your questions, being, active and sharing information and really helping people build their smart practices. And I think in 2021, it's only going to be greater. Every practice I know for the most part is hiring. People are opening their practices. Community mental health agencies are looking for people. Schools are bringing on mental health counselors and psychologists and social workers. Agencies who have never had mental health workers before are hiring. This is our time. I really, really want you to take that away. This is our time as mental health professionals. We need to seize the day. We need to seize the year. And so if you are seizing the day or seizing the year through a private practice, you've come to the right place. We're going to be providing lots of tools and tips on how to build a smart practice in 2021. So I hope you're with me on that journey. I'm going to give you one more tip, but first I want to thank our sponsor, Therapy Notes. If you're looking for an electronic health record, I really want you to check out Therapy Notes. They are a great electronic health record. It's who we use. And we use them because their reporting functions are so great. It's so easy to manage. They give you to-do lists. And on top of all the things that they do, the regular things, like they send reminders, you can take payments, you can bill insurance, you can write your notes, your treatment plans. They also have wonderful customer service. You can pick up the phone. You can say, hey, I have a question about this. This doesn't seem right. Or, I need some help around this. And they will help you. And they are wonderful. So I want you to check out Therapy Notes. So if you don't already have your business plan in place for 2021, I want you to do that. I want you to put your ideas down. It doesn't need to be a fully formed business plan. We actually put one together for my group practice for 2021 with some goals. We took a look at what we wanted to do and I broke it up into quarters and put our to-do list for the quarters. I'm really excited about it. And it wasn't like this full-on business plan. So make sure somewhere, somehow, you have your goals for 2021. And we will make it the best year it can possibly be in your private practice. So I will see you next year, everybody. Bye.